Hi beautiful people, and welcome to my vlog. I just kind of missed you, so I was like, I'm gonna come back on. I hope you're okay. My face is killing me this morning. Everything is hurting me this morning, but you know, like the hay fever, like face swelling up thing, you sort of see it does it here. I've taken some fexofenadine, which is like Allegra, which is like, I had that last year for my allergy stuff. But I feel like it does take like an hour or so to kick in. So I should really take it like at the same time every morning, and then I wouldn't have this like whatever lag, time lag thing. But yeah, it's really funny. Like I'm like, oh, I don't have hay fever, I don't have hay fever. And then like my nose is streaming and like my throat is itching. And like, oh, maybe I do. So yeah, that is me this morning. I am in a huge amount of pain, my whole body actually. I kind of have been all week, maybe not yesterday so much, which is really infuriating, but it's just the situation with fibromyalgia and EDS. And I looked this morning at, I don't know if I told you, but my rheumatologist wasn't actually sure whether I had EDS. He was like, I need to look up the subtypes, and I looked them up this morning, and there's one called, I think it's myopathic, which like fits me actually quite a lot. So yeah, I think I'm gonna, he's probably had a look now and as well, and is like, oh yeah, that one. Because he was like, I don't remember all the subtypes, even though he's a rheumatologist, but it's fine, letting it go. So yeah, I'm speaking to the doctor today as well. She arranged the appointment with me, so I'm not 100% sure what it's about, but I think it's about pain management. And like, I'm sat here like really infuriated because I would love to be on pain management, but I just had such bad side effects from the last lot. I'm too scared to go on them again. Like in the sense that you have to take them for like a prolonged period of time. And if you miss a dose, like you are a mess. And I think I'm just too forgetful to risk that. Like particularly like Saturday mornings, for whatever reason, I always forget to take tablets on Saturday mornings. If I'm on like a regular, like when I'm on the pill and stuff like that. Oh my God, moisturizer. Sorry, I've got the window open and the world has suddenly appeared outside. So yeah, I'll be interested to see what she has to say, to be honest, because I think I said to you last week, I really wasn't expecting her to book an appointment with me. So I don't really know what it's about. But yeah, and I've also got my other interview today for the cleaning job. I've also been offered a job in a nursery as a bank role, so that's like literally could be once a month. But do you remember I was saying I was like applying to all of them and like I hadn't heard anything back, and I was like, I'm giving up, I'm just going to do the cleaning job. Like I would love to work in a nursery, it's just like the hours that are the problem. But she said that she could do the 4-hour shift, so I'm just waiting to hear back from her and see what the next steps are there, because that could be really exciting, could be a really fun job for me. And like I think what would be good is like getting the skills, so like if I get a cleaning job and a nursery job, then I can say I've had that experience. And like you can pick up nursery jobs and cleaning jobs anywhere in the world really, so if I do end up moving abroad, as the tarot and the astrologers and the psychics say I will, then I've got options. I have no idea why we would move abroad at this point. I'm actually getting, like yesterday we were driving around and I was like, you know what, I'd be okay here. I'd be okay in this area. It wouldn't be the worst thing, do you know what I mean? So, at all actually, it's beautiful around here. It's just like my fear of people that's the problem. I had therapy on Tuesday. I don't know if we spoke, I don't think we spoke. I think we might have spoken on Tuesday, but before therapy, which was really, 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 really intense. Like we went way back to like early childhood stuff that I don't think either of us were expecting that conversation to go there, but it just did. And the rest of the day was a complete write-off. Like I got back home and I was like, well, I had to stop on the way back to cry in the car, just because it was really intense, and I think my body was like processing probably a lot as well. But yeah, so like, yeah, the rest of that day I was on my phone and watching TV, mainly on my phone actually, just on like TikTok and Instagram, like trying to, almost like trying to like just keep my brain so busy I couldn't think. I think that's what I was doing. And I just sort of let myself do that. I was like, today can be a write off, that's fine. Like that was really hard shit. So I did just sort of let that go. And then yesterday, got out in the sun in like the little courtyard, completely took all my clothes off because nobody can see me out there. It's the first house I've ever lived in where the garden, this isn't really a garden, it's like literally just a tiny courtyard, but I can put a chair there. It's completely like, not completely, but like no one's gonna see me basically. So that's so exciting for me. So I've got like a tan, and I wrote 4,000 words. You know, the average daily writing of for a novelist is 500 words. And I did 4,000. So like it really made up for like not writing the day before. Which I thought, I think probably subconsciously I knew that. I was like, well, it's fine because I know I can make up for it. And like not being funny, but if I'm writing 4,000 words a day, sky shush. And my book really for self-help, you're aiming for 40 to 50,000 words. I'm on 22,000 words at the moment. Do you know what I mean? Like I'm in the sort of the end run now. I'm running towards the finish line, and it's, yeah, hitting that yesterday, I was like, oh my god, like I hit my halfway yesterday. I was like, this is so exciting, like so exciting. Just think, like, and I think I like read back through my work, and like I've written other books, I've written kids books and like teen novels and poetry books. And I look back and I'm like, oh, I don't like it, I'm not sure about that. And edit. And that's why I never like push them very far because I just question them so much. Whereas this writing, I look at it and I'm like, this is really good stuff. This is gonna change the way people think about themselves. And that's my intention, you know? Leave this as my legacy, effectively. I've also been doing letters to my therapist sort of series online on Instagram and TikTok. Really annoying, like TikTok's just like, at first it was like, yeah, we'll share it. And then it was like, nah. And it's just so annoying because like particularly the last episode I sent out was probably one of the best ones so far. And like to prove that to you, the fact that I literally went on this morning and it's the same, on Instagram it's probably like 1,500 people see these reels. But the one today had 13 saves, one yesterday had 13 saves, which like that makes me feel so good because I'm like, it's affecting people in a positive way. They are feeling heard, they are feeling like they're not alone. And like honestly, that is my intention. Like I need people to, like, because I know there's so many people out there who felt like I felt and feel like they're the only ones, and it can be so isolating. And if I can just show to people that they're not alone, like that to me, honestly, just, it makes the world of difference. And it's infuriating because I'm like, I know that they could go viral should Instagram like me, but it doesn't like me. Like I saw somebody yesterday, had like 500 views on her stories and she had 2,000 followers. I have 20,000 followers and I get like 150 views on my stories. I know that's really petty. I know that is really petty, but it's just, I don't understand because like, obviously like some of my stuff is like annoying and weird. But at the other end of the spectrum, I follow people whose stories are annoying and weird. And like, I kind of enjoy that. So it's just like really frustrating for me that I don't get the exposure that I think I deserve. And it sounds like you're not owed anything, but I feel like it does annoy me because with that exposure, people are being helped. You know, that's my intention. So I don't know. Maybe that's the point. Maybe Instagram doesn't want people to be helped. I don't know. And who knows, like that could change, like they could pick up on them soon and really take off and stuff. But either way, I'm glad to have made them. I think I might make a couple more today. I've got 9 or 10 out, like ready to go out anyway. So, and I'm on 4, so yeah. Well, anyway, that's that side of things. I was gonna say I have a cleaning interview today, yeah, and I have my nursery interview, already said that. Personal life, we met some friends yesterday that I've never met before. They're Alex's friends, and oh my god, that was so exciting. Like me in a social situation, like I don't get exposed to that very often, like meeting strangers that, sky shush darling please, meeting strangers that are like friends, like our age group, and like I fucking got such a high off it. I was like, oh my god. And I wonder, I have been thinking, I think that my next big chapter, which I think is probably next year and like to do with the book maybe, is going to involve way more social settings, because like, I know it sounds crazy, but I'm so wasted in that sense. Like, I'm such a joy in social situations that I want to be in. And I do feel like I'm wasted at the moment, just like, I don't have exposure to people, and like, I feel like I could do so much to help other people and like give my gifts, give all the diplomas I've learned like out to the world. I just don't have that exposure right now. So I do wonder if that's what's coming next. And that excites me, the fact that like, it'd be a shame if that wasn't utilized, and it's like those moments where like I walk away from social situations, I'm like, wow, I feel so good. That really made my energy pick up. Like, it'd be a shame if that was wasted. I mean, I'm 25, I've got time. But these are the things I think about, you know? So, yeah. Today I'm going to write some more. I'm very excited about that. And I don't know what to do about my pain situation. So I've taken Fexo, so I could probably take a lot of other stuff. It just honestly doesn't make a difference. And like, that's, I think, the problem now is I just don't know what to do about my pain. And like this morning, it was like my upper back and my shoulders, which that's only really been happening recently. And it's just like, I was actually woke up this morning and I was like, I'm gonna need to think of like, am I gonna need to sleep in some kind of foam mold so that my body doesn't like, like some kind of neck support. I was thinking maybe I should get a neck brace and like a back brace so that I'm like, I don't know if that's what's making it worse. I don't sleep, like I'm awake the whole night. It was like 3 o'clock and I was just like, staring at the ceiling like, I'm not even fighting it. I'm like, fine. Yeah, it's just how it is. So it is really tough, but we keep going. And I'm very optimistic at this point, I'm like now, and I'm really excited for my book, and I'm really excited for like the opportunities with my house and with getting more money. So it's great to be in this frame of mind. I love you lots. Let's talk soon.